team. And if you're my team, what I'd say to you is, man, I hope yesterday you made a decision. And if you didn't make a decision yesterday, I hope you make one today. I hope it's not one of those decisions where you just take out your pen and you write it in a book, and you go home, that book goes on a shelf. And you never look at it again. And you don't make any lasting changes in your life. Because you know, integrity is a promise that you keep to yourself. And you make a promise to yourself, and you don't keep it, you lose a little bit of your soul, and I truly believe that. My name is Jeff Brookshire from Diamond Bar, California. I want to thank my amazing wife, Michelle. Without her, I wouldn't be here today. That's 100% true. And I also want to thank my team, the Warriors. Guys, it's an honor to fight with you side by side as we fight for our dreams. It really is. So thank you for being here. You know, I worked for 25 years in corporate America, aside from a 2-year stint in the movie business. And I'll tell you this, I was good at it. I'm not one of those stories where I said, man, I didn't have other choices. I had other choices. I made 6 figures. I was good at what I did. And I had 2 things that made me good in our business. The first thing was I had a philosophy. My philosophy was always take care of your customer. My second philosophy was, even more important than the first, is always take care of your team. And those attributes bled over into WFG. So my wife, first of all, I gotta tell you, I wasn't really happy at Target. I really wasn't. I mean, I was making okay money, and I had a chip on my shoulder. You guys ever have a chip on your shoulder? I think people have a chip on their shoulder make pretty good WFG agents. I'll tell you why. I always felt like there was something more I was supposed to do. You guys ever feel like that? Of course you do, because you're here today, right? So my wife joined WFG without my knowledge. Right? She didn't tell me because I would have told her, don't do that, it's a scam, right? It's one of those things. And I came home from Target one day and I was exhausted from work and she said, hey, listen, let's go out for a beer and a burger. I said, well, as long as good craft beer, I'm down, right? I'll do that. So we did, and on the way there, she drove to an office in Chino, which was Dan's office, and I'm like, what are we doing here? So I saw WFG, and I was impressed, and we joined. 2 months later, fired my boss, burned my ships. We signed a lease for our office as senior associates, and we never looked back. And now we came back today, a little bit over 5.5 years later, as an EDC team. We're a new one, we're a small one, but I gotta tell you, we're excited, and we feel like we're just beginning this thing. And it sounds like a rocket ship. It really felt like a tugboat. I felt like sometimes the tugboat was sinking, but at any rate, I'm not here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about creating a winning team. And for me, there are about 8 things you need to focus on when you're creating a winning team. The first thing is, you need to set a team goal. And it's gotta be a big one. And then when you achieve it, you gotta set another big one, and another big one. The second thing is probably more important than that for me. You gotta lead from the front. And think about this, how in the world can you ask somebody to do something that you're not doing yourself? Am I right?
Right.
Ask yourself this question. You go, look, if my team does exactly what I do on a daily basis, will they win? That's a sobering question. So you got big shoes to fill. The next thing is, you gotta find and build other leaders. That's one of the reasons that we had success, is we found and built other leaders. You can't be the hero to your entire hierarchy. You've got to build other heroes. We also have to work on self-mastery, right? You gotta be good. Because people don't join WFG, you guys know that? They join you. And you better be good, and you better be honest, and you better be hardworking, and you better have some identity, and you better have a little bit of swagger, right? You gotta have that stuff. And speaking of swagger, your environment's gotta be good too. Like your team, when you walk into your BPM, each team has to feel like, man, we're the best in the company. Right? How else would you like to feel? Right? We need diversity. We need unity. We need family. That's what an environment should be. And so if your environment has great identity, you can recruit those with great identity. That's one of the secrets. Big vision. You know, Ed asked me one time, he said, Jeff, what's your vision for your team? Because people are primarily visual by nature. And I said, I've always liked knights, and I've always liked warriors, and I've always liked fighting. I always felt like I had to fight for what I got in life. And I said, well, my vision is a round table. Like the knights of the round table, right? But instead of knights around the round table, I want to have individuals that Michelle and I have turned into millionaires around the round table. And so our team is looking at that vision and they go, man, I'm going to fight for my seat at that table. So you got to have a big vision. Number seven is you can't be comfortable. Good God, this is not the place to be comfortable. The grave, that's a good place to be comfortable. And last but not least, if you know me, there are two attributes there are a lot of attributes I don't have, but two I do have is focus and consistency. Like, I got to tell you, there's so many distractions in life, aren't there?
Yeah.
We're here in Sin City. It's a city of distractions, isn't it?
Yeah.
So is your home. So is your job. You got to be like a laser. You gotta be laser focused on where you're going. You gotta be like a bullet. You know, a bullet doesn't look to the left, a bullet doesn't look to the right. A bullet just keeps going. And you gotta work on that daily consistency. So, I wanna challenge you guys to fight. I want you to fight for your lives. You're in a fight for your lives, whether you know it or not. You're fighting for the life you could have, the person you could become, and the team and business you could build. And I hope to God you go home after this convention and you fight for it like you really mean it. Look in the eyes of your wife or your husband or your kids and go, man, we're going to make this thing work because you deserve it. That's all I got. Love you guys. God bless.
Is absolutely priceless.
And I tell you what, this man is the love of my life. I'm giving it over to Jeff LaHovia.
Am I a lucky man or what? Yeah, am I lucky? You know, Marcy and I had our first date after a company convention in a little cafe at Bally's over 20 years ago. And I gotta tell you, I fell in love that night. I tell you what, I fell in love. And you know, also, you know what? We found and fell in love with the dream business. And together, we've been building a dream life for over 22 years we've been married. And I tell you what, good persistency, no charm down. We've been together a long time. And you know what, I feel like we're just getting started. You know, every dream, right, has a before and after picture, and I'm gonna tell you a little bit about ours, but I'll tell you one of the biggest things I learned from this company was that if you don't build your own dream, someone else will hire you to help build theirs, right? And I gotta tell you something that I learned, you know, from this company, that you know what, you don't have to settle. You don't have to do what people think is realistic, right? And I gotta tell you, I believe this. I believe that using realistic as an excuse for thinking small denies what's possible, and it denies who you really are. I believe that. Right? Look, guys, I gotta tell you something. The first convention I came to years ago, I was living at home in my parents' basement in this house in Wisconsin. And I tell you what, I could barely afford to come here. But I tell you what, it changed my life. It changed my life that someone invited this young kid to a BPM a long time ago. And you know what? Within a couple years, we had our lives completely changed beyond recognition. You know, we were married, we bought our first dream house together. It's the Starter WFT house in a gated community. And you know, you can take a picture of a house, but you can't take a picture of freedom, can you? And I tell you, that's the greatest thing that we had is a dream business that gave us freedom. You know, you also cannot take a picture of how hard this is. And I want you to know this may be harder than you thought it was gonna be. But you know what else is hard? Having a job you don't like is hard too, right? Being broke is hard, being dead is hard, never being able to retire is hard, saying no to your kids is hard, it's all hard, isn't it? I believe you gotta choose your challenge, and this is a challenge worth choosing. Right? Look, I gotta tell you something. We started winning trips together. Our first trip to Hawaii was 2 weeks after we were married. Don't laugh at my shoes, all right? That's what you wear when you're from Wisconsin on your first trip to Hawaii, right? And not to laugh, but I should have said it. But look, we've been on more trips than I can count. I was never on an airplane before I was in this company. We've been on more trips than I can even count. And I gotta tell you, it's just been amazing going to Hawaii, you know, 22 times. You know, my daughter now is 9 years old. She's been to Hawaii 9 times, right? When I went to, on family vacations growing up, we went to the woods and camping, and man, she's got a freaking flyer mind, right? She's got Hello Kitty luggage, right? She thinks it's normal to go to Hawaii every year. And you know what? If you're a WFT kid, it probably is, isn't it? Right? All right, guys, look. I gotta tell you, you know, from dog sledding to going to Europe more times than I can count, gondolas and Greece, you know, having great friends on trips with us, like Gary Ziegler going to Hawaii. That's us by lava, right? That's pretty cool. I didn't know you could sit by lava. You know, Tom Hansen mud bugging in Hawaii where they filmed Jurassic Park. So many amazing things, you know? We've had trips with great mentors like the Levitans. There's a dream castle there in Germany, Castle Neu Schwanstein, right? You know, we've had trip of a lifetime, multiple times and many times. You know, horse-drawn carriage, waltzing at palaces, just amazing. All because this man, Greg Capp, gave me a BPM before he even had an office. Right? Changed my life. World-class trips and world-class people, it's amazing. But the best thing that's happened, you know, is my wife and I have been able to dream together for all these years. It's been an amazing experience, right? Look, I gotta tell you, you know, I believe this quote is that first dreams seem impossible, right? Then improbable, and then inevitable. And I believe that's why we're here today, just to see how inevitable it is if you stick with this and don't quit. All right, guys, recent dream came true for us. We moved into a country club where one of Jeff Levitan's properties are. And by the way, that's not the house, that's the gatehouse. And for years, I drive up to that gatehouse and go, I moved to Levitan's, here's my guest pass. And a year and a half ago, I went to the guard and said, you know what? I don't need this pass no more. I'm a resident. I high five him. You know what? And he joined the team, of course, right? I mean, he says, man, tell me how you did that, right? It's awesome. 2-acre estate over there, a dream come true. It's just unbelievable. Man, I'll tell you what, I'm a lucky man, right? A dream business. You know, I believe sharing the dream is the best thing that we can do for people in the world. You know, stretching their vision, seeing something for them that maybe they hadn't seen. You know, there's a great saying here that says Martin Luther gave the I have a dream speech, not the I have a plan speech, right? Dreams are so much more powerful than plans, aren't they? Okay? Look, what does your bait shop look like today? Hey, the good news is that the before picture has nothing to do with the future, right? These are some of the wealthiest people in the world today, right? That's Bill Gates and Paul Allen. You know, I believe the team that performs together transforms together. You know, 1995, that's what my bait shop looked like right there. That's right after Marcy and I got married. As many years ago, a few pounds ago. Marcy looks the same. I've changed a little bit. We got around some great mentors like Rich Dolly, Greg Capp, and Jeff Levitan. And you know what? Before you know it, broke kids started getting their $100,000 rings. You know what? This is Gary Zegler's wedding here. We stood up at his wedding. You know, he came to a meeting. Someone said, you know what? He's so shy and quiet, it's not right for you to get his hopes up here. It's not fair for you to get him excited. But you know what? That person's still broke today. You said that. Gary Zegler made $100,000 the second year, and in June in this company, he was paid over $125,000. Isn't that awesome? Right? Fast forward many years and millions of dollars later, right? What we found is that, you know what? You can have anything in life that you want if you just help enough other people get what they want. Right, and now you know we're sharing that dream. Right now, this is Alvin Darren's wedding. We do the ring pose over there. We got people. We got six people now making over $250,000 a year. People like Alvin Darren, Tavares Dove, Gary Zegler, Tom Hansen, just awesome, right? Look, guys, I want to tell you this. I think you know what? More people here that join your team are going to quit than come in. Isn't that true? You got to be ready to handle that. And you know what? Marcy and I, it's kind of like a gym. That's how I look at it. You know, Marcy and I got our new home and. You know, there was a gym there called Lifetime Fitness, and man, I went to that place, they had everything there, man. They had rock climbing, swimming, camp for kids, everything, month to month. And you know what I joined? And I'm not saying it's the best gym in the world, but it's the best gym in the world. And I refer anybody to that gym. But if they don't show up, it's not my fault, right? I can't show up for them. I can show up with them, I can encourage them, but I can't show up for them. And I believe WG is the same way. I'm not saying WT is the best company in the world, but it's the best company in the world. I refer anybody to WT, but if they don't show up, it's not my fault, right? I can encourage them, I can show up with them, but I can't show up for them, right? I believe that. I'm going to share with you guys one last quote here to finish up my talk. You know, it inspires me all the time because, you know, at one time they believed it was impossible to climb Mount Everest, right? And, you know, people were dying trying, and a guy named Sir Edmund Hillary, he tried, he failed. But he said, I will come back and conquer you because as a mountain you can't grow, but as a human being I can. And I believe WG is the same way. The obstacles here won't grow, but we can. Guys, let's grow together. We'll see you at the top.
Would they win?